So last night when we got into the campsite, we didn't realize till it was dark, but this window, you see, got smashed. We're thinking what happened is when we were on the dirt road, TransCanada was under construction there, so it was dirt for about, I don't know, 2 kilometers or something like that. And we think that stones got thrown from the tires of the Jeep, hit the side of the windows. I don't know if you can see, but it's like spider cracked the whole way. So we are gonna tape this window. So hopefully it doesn't get worse. I thought I was filming this, but I guess I didn't. Anyways, here's our sick tape job.
Did you tape the first part where it was broken?
Looks mint. Yeah, I think I did. Camera noob. Alright, just so that we don't smash another window, we stopped and we picked up one of these, I don't know what you call them. What do you call this thing? Did they say what the name was? I don't know. Basically, it's like a mud flap for trailers. Hopefully that will protect us from getting another smashed window. The Jeep got a new dress, or a skirt. As we got here at Transcona Trailer Sales, the parts guy came out and helped us install it and everything. Because you need a drill and a bunch of other tools, which we didn't have. So, this is Transcona in Winnipeg. If you guys need anything for your trailer, come to these guys.
Flat Earth people, we are in Manitoba, pushing close to the border for Saskatchewan. I guess the closest town is Verdun.
We're 30 kilometers from the border.
Yeah, and
Saskatchewan.
Jordan and Samantha are back in Ontario, and it's like getting pretty dark there. And if I turn the camera around, look where the sun is. It's still way up there in the sky, so Earth's got to be round.
Hey, you better record this phone call.
Fake! Yeah, you're right. We probably did record this phone call. It just timed it perfectly so that I could, like, actually respond to what you guys are saying and you can respond to what I'm saying. That's more plausible, actually. I'm pretty sure the Earth must... It must be flat.
Yeah.
Don't
say that, dude. You'll have a whole tangent on your video. Wait, that doesn't prove it's round. That just proves it's not keep going.
Yeah, it does. If it was flat, then you would still be able to see the sun too.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
The sun would be at the same height for you as it is for me, right?
Oh, yeah.
No? Now I'm thinking about it.
Wait, no. Wait. No.
I was thinking about it. I'll tell you, I think the Earth is flat in Saskatchewan, probably.
Yeah, it's
wait, now you think about it.
What if it's a cube?
A cube?
Yeah.
Well, when do we go over that 90 degree corner?
What the heck was that?
What the heck was what?
There was like a fox or something in front of
the cube.
Really?
Yeah.
I missed it.
You missed everything.
The camera was pointing the wrong way.
Yeah. Mario Party
level? Mario Party?
Morning, baby. You want to get out of here? Do you wanna come before a car ride? Do you wanna go see Regina? Yeah, that much? You really wanna go?
Morning. We're in Regina. Still in Walmart parking lot.
Looks like it's gonna be a sunny day.
Stopped in there, just a small town gas station, and there's a guy getting fuel there on a KLR, a young guy, probably around my age, in his 20s anyways. I asked him where he's from. He's from Utah. I asked him what he's doing way up here. Said he's traveling across Canada for the 150, which I thought was pretty neat. I didn't think Americans would really be that interested in our celebration. But he said he left Utah, drove over to Los Angeles, and then drove north on the Pacific Highway and then British Columbia, came across Alberta, and now here he is here in Morse, Saskatchewan, heading all the way to the East Coast. Pretty neat. But he said this wind is not too good on the motorcycle, and I believe him. Like, it's causing us to have terrible fuel mileage on the Jeep. I can just imagine how he's feeling with this kind of wind kind of at his back, pushing him all over the place. But it's kind of neat to see someone from Utah. Real friendly guy, nice guy. Cool motorcycle, loaded up, had all the gear. I just Instagrammed for the first time. Hashtag Instagram noob. It was the crappiest picture of the sunset ever. The foreground is blurry. You can barely see the clouds. There's trees in the way. It's really bad. Hey, I'm wearing my sunglasses that night because I'm so cool. Double rainbow. It is a double rainbow.
What does it mean? Look at it. What does it all mean?
I bet you the camera can't see it. Pray.
Jeez.